This video is going to show you how to sterilize used coffee grounds with hydrogen peroxide so that you can grow oyster mushroom mycelium. You're going to need used coffee grounds, 1 to 2 kitchen sieves or strainers, a large spoon, a sterilized bucket, hydrogen peroxide, a measuring cup, and lots of tap water. As you can see, we have our coffee. We're going to add hydrogen peroxide and water to the bucket of used coffee grounds at a ratio of 1 to 10. For example, every cup of hydrogen peroxide, we add 10 cups of water. The amount varies depending on the coffee ground quantity. Try and make sure that the coffee grounds are completely submerged. Also, a fair warning, watch your clothes. Don't wear anything that you wouldn't want to get accidentally stained or bleached. Hydrogen peroxide can do that to your clothes. You will notice that when we add the hydrogen peroxide that there may be a bit of a fizz layer on the top. Just like when you put hydrogen peroxide on a cut, how it foams a little and turns white, that's what's happening in the bucket at a bit of a larger scale because it's killing all the bacteria and the spores that are in the coffee grounds. Stir it up, make sure you reach to the very bottom and all the coffee grounds are being mixed up. Now, scoop the coffee ground mixture into a strainer. These are regular kitchen strainers, and the mesh is fine enough to prevent the grounds from escaping. Once you've got enough in the strainer, you're going to rinse with tap water. And sit aside to finish straining. And you're going to repeat the process until all the coffee grounds are sterilized. Scoop the coffee ground mixture into the strainer, rinse thoroughly with tap water, set the strainer aside to finish draining, and put the sterilized coffee grounds into a sterilized bucket. Now, there are many different ways to sterilize. This is just what we do at the lab. I've seen people sterilize coffee grounds in a microwave. They can do it by putting them in the oven for a certain amount of time at a certain temperature. We also freeze ours because we get them in large quantities that we can't always use, so that's just the way we store them. That also eliminates a lot of bacteria. And then once they thaw, they'll be exposed to spores in the air, so we also sterilize them with hydrogen peroxide. Now, once you've finished your bucket, you have successfully sterilized all your used coffee grounds.